Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and we are going to start exploring the wonderful world of the skeletal muscle tissue at a more microscopic level, with a focus on the skeletal muscle fibers, which are really just another name for the muscle cell. Muscle cells are called muscle fibers because of their relatively long shape. So you will hear me say both muscle cell or muscle fiber very interchangeably, and both are fair game for assessment. Before we talk about the composition of the muscle fiber, so the organelles and what's inside them, in this video we're going to discuss how these cells actually form, and importantly, how they grow, how they get bigger. And we will finish our conversation talking about satellite cells, which are closely associated with muscle cells. Alright, during embryonic development, hundreds of myoblasts, which are these small mesodermal cells, are going to start their mesodermal cells, which, remember, the mesoderm is one of the germ layers. So they will start to kind of collect together, and they will begin to fuse, and they will continue to fuse until you have a mature muscle cell, which you're looking at right here. And that mature muscle cell will have hundreds of nuclei, and that's all because of how it formed, with these multiple cells fusing together, which still you would have those nuclei. So that is why you see all these nuclei throughout. Once a muscle cell is fully fused and considered mature, cell division is not possible. All right, so in order for a muscle cell to get larger, which we know muscles are capable of, think of a bodybuilder, but even just regular muscle growth through the juvenile period. So for it to get larger, the muscle cell has to hypertrophy. All right, which hypertrophy is going to be the enlargement of existing muscle fibers. And this hypertrophy is possible by the increased production of structures within the cell. So most notably, the myofibrils, which we'll talk about what that is in a bit more detail in subsequent videos. But you could also have other portions of the cell that will enlarge or increase. And that would be the sarcoplasm, the sarcoplasmic reticulum, mitochondria, and other organelles, so that you'd have an increased production of these organelles. So it is hypertrophy, not hyperplasia, which would be an increase in the number of cells. So you're not getting more cells. The cells that exist are getting larger. During childhood, certain hormones like human growth hormones or sex hormones can lead to the hypertrophy of the existing cells. But after the juvenile period, usually it's more muscle hypertrophy occurring due to repeated forceful muscular activity like weight training. And that can certainly lead to an increase in muscles in juveniles as well. Some myoblasts can persist and be closely associated with skeletal muscle cells. And some research shows that these cells retain some capacity to fuse with one another or with damaged muscle fibers. But I do want to also note that there's quite a bit of ongoing research regarding satellite cells, and some have some conflicting findings. We're going to kind of go with what a lot of the textbooks say. So the number of satellite cells are typically not enough to compensate for significant skeletal muscle damage, which if you have that significant damage, that would lead to something called fibrosis, which is the replacement of damaged muscle fibers with fibrous scar tissue. And just think, if you had that fibrous scar tissue, that would really limit the functions and capabilities of the muscles. So satellite cells can play a role in terms of helping damaged muscle cells, but not to a significant extent if you have significant damage. Okay, our question for this video is very big picture, something I definitely want you to take away from this video. So true or false, muscle grows via hyperplasic or plastic activity. Sometimes you'll hear plasic activity. So is this true or false? And when ready, what do you say? Do you say true or false? And if you said false, why? Well, the answer is false. All right, so false is correct. Muscles grow through hypertrophy, not hyperplastic or hyperplasic activity. So it would be trophy here. Oop. Mark that out there. Muscle cell fibers arise before birth through the fusion of those myoblasts, and most cells will last a lifetime. If it were hyperplasia, that would be an increase in the number of muscle cells, which we know we have a pretty set amount after birth. Excellent, great work, and if you missed this, no problem. You just now know that you need to review this area a bit more, which isn't uncommon when learning something new. As always, please feel free to reach out to me with any questions. Thank you for your time and attention.